this video, we're going to talk about the central limit theorem. So let's start with a random sample. Let's denote that random sample x1 through xn. It's a random sample of size n, and we need each one of these to have finite variance. But really, because it's a random sample, then that means that they all have the same distribution, which means that the variance of x1 is the same as the variance of xn, and the expected value of x1 is the same as the expected value of xn. And so really we just need to check, is the variance of x1 finite? Now let's denote mu as the expected value of x1, and let's have sigma squared equal the variance of x1. Now let's say that x bar n is equal to 1 over n times the sum of the xi. So in other words, it's a sample mean from the first n random variables. Then the CLT says that x bar n minus mu divided by sigma over root n is going to converge to a standard normal distribution as n increases to infinity. All right, so again, what is this saying? If we have any random variables that are IID with finite variance, then x bar n minus mu over sigma over root n is going to converge to a standard normal distribution. Now this is a very powerful theorem, because we don't have any distributional assumptions on these x's besides the fact that we need finite variance. So these x's could have a normal distribution, or they could have a Poisson distribution, they could have an exponential distribution, they could have any distribution. It might not even have a special name. As long as the variance of each one of these x's is finite, then x bar n minus mu over sigma over root n is going to converge to a standard normal distribution as n increases to infinity. All right, so let's do a little example with this one. So you order food every day and you record your waiting time from day I as xi. Now suppose the distribution of wait times is IID. So in other words, as time passes, the wait time does not change on average. The distribution of the wait times does not change as time passes. So it's IID with mean theta and variance theta squared. Now, let's talk about what the central limit theorem would say for your average wait time. What it says is x bar n minus mu, which in this case is theta, divided by, now we need the square root of the variance. Variance is theta squared, so we have theta over root n. All of this is going to converge to a standard normal distribution as n goes to infinity. All right, so lots of times people will take this and rewrite it in what my dissertation advisor called the sloppy version of the central limit theorem. So people like to write x bar n minus mu over sigma over root n is approximately following a standard normal distribution for large n. Now, as soon as you write that something is going to be true for large enough n, then people love to ask, well, what's a large enough value of n? And of course, if you look at any textbook, well, most textbooks love to say that n greater than 30 is large enough for this to hold. Now, I definitely disagree. I think that it definitely varies based on what the distribution of the x's looks like. If we have x's that have a normal distribution already, then of course this sloppy CLT is going to be very good. If we have a distribution that's very skewed, then it's going to take a sample size much larger than 30 in order for this sloppy CLT to be any good. All right, so there we have it, the formal version of the central limit theorem, the sloppy version of the central limit theorem, and one example to help us understand how we might be able to apply it.